हेलो चिल्ड्रन, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। वेलकम टू द वर्चुअल क्लास प्रेजेंटेड बाय जेट किड्स। सो डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक द यस क्लास टू साइंस पीरियड। सो इन दिस पीरियड व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द लेसन नंबर 6। यस मीन्स इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्टेड दिस लेसन। ओके, सो व्हाट वी हैव लर्न इन द लास्ट वीडियो और डिस्कस, यस देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फूड एंड दैट वी हैव टू टेक इन अ प्रॉपर अमाउंट। लाइक देर आर 3 फूड ग्रुप्स मेनली। One is the energy giving food, second one is the body building food, and third one is the protective food. Yes, so whatever we are taking, we should take from each food group. We have to select the items and then we have to take these foods in our meal. So by doing this we can stay healthy, fit and fine. Okay, so let us see today's topic, and today's topic is meals in a day. Okay, so see. Okay, so see, meals in a day means we eat different types of food at a different times of the meal of the day. Yes, means sometimes we eat in the morning, sometimes we eat in the afternoon, in the evening or at night. Okay, sometimes. So see, so these are times, whatever the whatever we are eating in this particular time, it has special names, and that you already know also. Okay, so that we are going to discuss in detail. Okay, so we eat different types of food at different times of the day. What we eat each time is called a meal. So whatever we are taking this time, that is called as meal. We usually eat 3 meals in a day. Yes, generally we have 3 meals in a day. Okay, so small children, okay, they can eat many time, no problem. But generally the human beings or the we elder people, generally we have 3 meals in a day. So whatever we take in the morning, that is our breakfast. Yes, and whatever we eat at the noon time or at the afternoon, in the afternoon, that is called as lunch. And whatever we take at night, that is called as dinner. Okay, so we should have meals at a fixed time every day. Suppose children, if you are eating any time, okay, whenever you feel that time, now any time after 1 hour, 2 hour, or frequently if you are taking, that is not a good thing, or that is not a good eating habit. So see student, we should have a fixed time of eating also. Okay, but if we have the particular time timetable of eating, then we will not going to face any health issue. Okay, we will be healthy more and fit, we will be stay fit and fine. So that's why we should have our particular timetable or fixed time of eating. So let us see. So see, breakfast in the morning. Yes, we should have our breakfast in the morning. See student, I'm going to explain this breakfast word, why the name is given breakfast, whatever we take in the morning. So see, at night we sleep. Yes, and whenever we are taking at night, that is called as dinner. After the dinner, from the dinner to till the morning, okay, after the dinner till the morning, we do not take anything, means our fast is there. Okay, and in the morning we are breaking that fast, that's why it is called as breakfast. Understood why it is called as breakfast? Means we are taking something and we are breaking our fast, that is why it is called as breakfast. Okay students, so breakfast we are taking in the morning. Whatever you are taking, suppose tea, coffee, milk, okay, or bread, yes, biscuits, whatever, okay, or some light snacks like poha or like upma, yes, whatever you are taking, that is your breakfast. Okay, let us see the next, lunch. Okay, so lunch in the afternoon. So whatever we have the meal which we take in the afternoon, that is called as lunch. Okay, or in the school time we have lunch break. Okay, because generally at 11:30 or quarter to 11 or 11 to 12, that during this time we are taking lunch. If our school is morning school, okay, if our school, because our school is morning school, yes, and generally the people, the children, those who are in the afternoon school, yes, means the from 11 to 5, they have lunch time at 2 o'clock. Okay, so like this, or 1:30 or 1 o'clock, whatever. So lunch we take in the afternoon. Okay, so whatever the meal we take in the afternoon, that is called as lunch. So see the picture and see the sun. Sun is above the head. Okay, that's why this is our lunch time. Let us see the next part. Yes, and whatever the meal that we take at night, that is called as dinner. See the background. Okay, the moon is given there, stars is given there. Okay, and they are having their dinner. So this is called as dinner which we take at night. The meal which we take at night is called as dinner. So I hope you understood what is meant by breakfast, lunch and dinner. So let us move to the next part. So see, healthy eating habits. So the next heading is healthy eating habits. Students, I already told you that we should have good eating habits, okay? And if we have the good eating habits, then we will be obviously healthy. So see, good food habits help us. Good food habits. Food habits means whatever we are eating, whatever we are doing every day, that is our habit, okay? And good food habit means the habits which are related of eating food, okay? I hope you understood the good food habit means. Good food habits help us to stay healthy, okay, and protect us from falling sick, okay. And let us learn about some healthy eating habits. So we are going to discuss one by one about healthy eating habits. So what is meant by good food habits? The food habits, whatever we are eating, okay, whatever we are doing every day, that is our habit. And good food habits means the habits of whatever we are taking properly on time, okay. So that if now we are going to discuss the healthy eating habits, so you will understand what are the good food habits. So let us see some more good food habits. So see, okay, so this is your first good food habit, okay. Wash the fruits and vegetables well before you eat them. So see, your mother is generally washing, but if your mother is busy, okay, and somebody gave you fruits and vegetables, okay, fruits suppose, so whatever you are eating like apple or whatever, so you have to wash it properly, okay. Wash the fruits and vegetables well before you eat them. And your mama is also washing the vegetables before cooking them. If you don't know, you can go and you can ask your mama, okay. So your mama will tell you that she is washing everything, fruits and vegetables also, okay. So today after watching this video, you can go and ask your mama. So let us see the next good food habit, okay. Yes, this is your next good food habit. Wash your hands with soap before and after eating every meal. Means before also and after the meal also, you have to wash your hands properly, okay, by using soap, okay. So next good food, and you, I know that you all are doing this, okay, because you are the good children of Jet Kids. Yes. So next good food habit is, yes, see, eat your food at regular intervals. Interval means after a period, after some time, okay, after a particular interval means period, means time. Interval means after time, means like in the morning, then in the afternoon, and then at night. So after a particular period or after a particular time, that is we can call as an interval. Eat your food at regular intervals, okay. So like now you eat, then you have to take after 4-5 hours again, then after 4-5 hours, so we can say like that, regular intervals, okay. So eat your food time to time, okay. So this is the good food habit. Let us see the next good food habit, okay. So the next good food habit is, never throw the waste or stale food around, always use a dustbin, okay. So see, now we have to keep our house clean, we have to keep our society clean, we have to keep our surrounding clean, okay, we have to keep our country clean, okay, ultimately, yes, we have to keep our town, city, state and country, yes. So see, we have to keep everything clean. So never throw the waste, okay, or the stale food around, okay, means here and there you are not going to throw anything. So always use a dustbin. Now what is meant by stale? So see, in detail they have given us the word wave, okay. So see, what is meant by stale? Stale means the food that is not fresh, okay. Stale food means like the food which is of the previous night or the last night, whatever, okay. So that food is not fresh, okay. So that is called as stale, okay. I hope you understood the meaning of the word stale. Stale, okay, stale means not fresh. So next good food habit is, eat food which is covered and protected from dust and flies. So you are not going to eat anything from the outside, okay. So whatever present in your house, your mama covered all the dishes whatever she made, okay. So otherwise you can observe, okay. So see, eat food which is covered and protected from dust and flies, okay. obviously net is there or the one okay, so pots are there, okay, they have the their okay utensils also properly covered, okay. So eat food which is covered and protected from the dust and flies. See in the picture, all the food is covered, okay, with the plates, okay. So in this way you have to cover, okay, all the foods and protected foods, okay. You have to protect the food from dust and flies also, because in the rainy season we have to face the problem of flies, okay, house flies especially. So that's why whatever, if the flies are there around that food, then you are not going to have that food, okay, because flies are very dangerous insect, okay. It keeps all the germs on that, okay. So for that you have to eat the food which is covered and protected. So see the next, okay. So see the next food habit is, good food habit is eat freshly cooked food, okay, and eat fresh vegetables and fruits. So after 2-3 days before whatever the stale food, you should not eat. You should eat freshly cooked food, okay. And generally your mama, you are a very good children of your mother and father, so obviously your mama gives a good fresh and cooked food only they are giving you, okay, or providing you. So you should eat freshly cooked food, okay, and you should not going to waste, you should not going to spill the food, okay. Eat fresh vegetables and fruits also, and fruits and vegetables also you have to eat freshly, okay. So see the next part. I hope you understood all the good food habits, and you are going to follow this. Now the next point is how to eat. So do not overeat, okay. Do not overeat. So see, do not overeat means see, some amount of food only we are going to take. So after 2 chapatis or 1 chapati or 2 chapati, if that is enough for you, then eat that much only. Don't take too much, okay, like then you have to face the problem of vomiting and all that. So eat whatever your fix. See, everybody we have a fixed amount of our meal, yes, that much only we can eat. Everybody has its capacity, so don't eat over your capacity. I hope you understood how to eat, the first point. Second point is eat slowly, okay. You have to eat slowly and chew your food well. See in the olden age, okay, it is said like that you should bite your one bite 32 times, okay. It is said like in a olden age, okay. You can ask your mama, okay, or your father. So eat slowly and chew your food well. If you are not going to chew it and you are going to eat it like this only, then you have to face the problem, okay. So then that food is difficult to digest, okay. So that's why I am going to tell you that you have to eat slowly and you have to chew your food well properly. Number 3, do not speak while eating. If you are going to speak, means now the time is, I always tell you that now at the time of eating, okay, in the tiffin time also, do eating or talking. So like that. So eating time, don't speak, okay, because then you have to face the problem of coughing or something, sneezing, anything you can face the problem, okay. So do not speak while eating. At the time of eating, do the work of eating only. Next, number 4, avoid eating food from the roadside vendors. So from outside food, obviously nowadays you are not going to going outside, but always keep into mind, before also and the next in future also, don't eat outside food. Whatever you want to like to eat, tell your mother to cook, okay. So next, number 5 is do not waste food, and we should respect food, okay. So we should respect the food, okay, because many people in the world, they do not get the food. So that's why we should not waste the food. If if it is possible for us to help the poor people, then we can help the poor children by donating the food. But we should not waste the food. Give animals like dog, cows and etc. Okay, but don't waste it. Okay, because we should respect each and everything which is present in our nature. Okay, so in this way, how to eat point you understood, and all these instruction your teacher is telling you. And not only your teacher is telling you, but your parents always tell you, okay. So you have to listen to them, okay, and you have to follow them. So the next part is sing along. There is one song that you have to learn, okay. So one time I will sing, next time you have to learn, okay. Grow, grow, grow and grow. Eat good food each day. Choose food from every group to help you work and play. So in this way you have to sing. Okay, let us see the next part. Okay, what is the next part? Let's say together. You have to say after me. You have to learn all this difficult spelling. You have to write down 3 times in your science notebook. Energy giving food, body building food, protective food, breakfast, lunch and dinner. Okay, so see the next part. Yes, keywords are there. Energy giving food means what? The food that gives us energy to work and play. These all definitions you have to write down in your science notebook and you have to learn. Body building food. Food that help us to grow and makes us strong and healthy. What is mean by protective food? Protective food means the food that protect us from falling sick. Okay. Meals in a day. We usually eat 3 meals in a day. Breakfast, lunch and dinner. So in short, we will take a summary. Okay. Or short revision we are going to take. Okay. So see, summary. Number one, what we learn in the lesson number 6, that is healthy food. Okay, so number one point is we need food to live and grow. Number two, energy giving food gives us energy. Yes. Number three, bodybuilding food help us to grow. Number four, protective food protects our body from falling sick. Number five, we must drink plenty of water every day. See, underline this sentence. It is a very, very important thing and you have to follow it also. Number six, we should eat meals at a regular intervals. And number seven, okay, we must develop good food habits to stay healthy and strong. So, dear students, okay, I hope you understood this lesson number 6. Yes, what is the name of the lesson? Healthy food. So in this lesson you are going to read this. What is your PH in this video? So your PH is you have to read the lesson properly from starting to end up to the summary. Okay, not only you are going to read, but you are going to follow, you are going to apply all the things whatever your teacher taught you. Okay, you are going to listen your parents especially. Okay children, so stay home, stay safe. Okay children, I hope you understood the lesson properly and try to solve the whatever the exercises in between the lesson. Till then, bye.